The food system in Minecraft is awful, and there are at least four reasons for it. It is unchallenging, it is shallow, it is annoying and unnecessary, and most importantly, you can't grow out of it. First, we take apart the current system, then I'll provide four potential solutions, and then we'll examine why other, often suggested solutions won't work. And then we'll move the discussion to the commons. Note, I'll focus primarily on survival, but I'll talk about PvP/minigames in its own section of the video. What do I mean by it's unchallenging? It's simple. You can have an infinite amount of the best food in the game on day one from either a villager breeder or a zoglin farm. Even if developers will do something to slow you down, well, you'll get there rather quickly anyway. It is shallow. It is also simple. There are two food types which are objectively better than anything else. They're simple to get. And the difference between these two doesn't matter if you eat as soon as you lose natural regeneration, and that's how usually people eat in Minecraft. Even if we would make them harder to get, thus forcing people to use intermediate food sources, it is not how you add depth. Depth is where you have a variety of consumable items, each of which is suited for a unique situation. No, scrap it. Here's the thing. You are not going to carry each unique food type for each possible scenario. Most likely, you are going to carry just one, the most optimal food source in the game that works decently well across most situations you face on a regular basis. It is annoying and unnecessary. I think we can all agree that there isn't anything satisfying about having to stop every now and then simply because game told you so. It doesn't really add anything to the game. It just disrupts you and takes you out of the flow. On top of it, food hogs an entire slot in your hotbar or your offhand, and given that the inventory hasn't been updated in 10 years, and the game needs an inventory update I've been talking about in another video of mine, this is a huge problem too. Here's the thing. Depleting mechanics in video games can have a place, but let's compare how Minecraft's hunger system works to something that is actually well thought. In Team Fortress 2, when you perform a rocket jump or a sticky jump, it depletes your health. The game actively wants to limit how many explosion jumps you can make, and you have to make use of health packs or medics if you want to expand that limit. Spice clocks work similarly. The game actively forces you to use it sparingly and learn how to use it effectively. So, depletion mechanics are there to limit certain activities. Which actions in Minecraft cause your hunger meter to go down, huh? Taking damage, sprinting, jumping, and mining. The game literally wants you to mine less. Yes, that sounds ridiculous. But how else should I interpret the game trying to slow me down for doing such core activities? Well, yes, I suppose it wasn't designed as an intentional penalty. But it means this penalty is the result of the lack of game design, the lack of attention to this aspect of the game. If I want to optimize my eating, I'll have to walk, not sprint, and I have to take long roundabouts instead of falling down and taking a smidge of fall damage. That's absurd. But surprise, other survival games have hunger and thirst mechanics. Minecraft is a survival game, thus it should have them too. Not necessarily. Here's an example. Overwatch is a team-based shooter, but unlike others, it doesn't have total ammo and fall damage. Another example. Factorio has had a pickaxe for a long time, but eventually they have dished it out because, quote, this was clearly Minecraft affecting our ideas, and a pickaxe was an unnecessary distraction. If something doesn't benefit your game, you don't have to have it just because other games have. Also, Minecraft is not really a survival game. Hear me out. When you have diamond ore, netherite gear, elytra and infinite food, which takes just a couple of days, you don't actually survive anymore. Mobs are no threat to you, and you don't have to manually gather the resources to stay alive. And you can just sleep the night away and avoid most of the combat. You know, there is a term that is passed around that describes this state of play. Even Jeb has used it. Conquest. Hermitcraft, Psycraft, and even yours truly. We don't survive. We conquer. We bend the world to our knees, we make farms, we build cool stuff, and so on. Having to do this is irrelevant to what Minecraft is truly about at this point. And this is where we get to you can't grow out of it. When your play transforms from survival to conquest, you'll start to make quality of life improvements. Tired of mining for iron? You make an iron farm. One of the best enchantment combinations in the game? Villager trading hall. Tired of the storage chaos? You make an automatic sorter. Tired of having to stop every now and then just to eat? Well, too bad, deal with it. And it is not like you can just ignore hunger or eat less often. Penalties are just way too harsh. Yeah, like that. You can make a contraption that prevents hostile mobs from spawning if you're dedicated enough, but you cannot get rid of this meaningless recurrent interruption. Speaking of meaningless recurrent interruptions, I think this is even worse than the food situation. By the way, have you ever played on a server with 10 people at the same time without one player sleep? I did. Having to AFK half the time because it is dark outside was very, very dumb and pointless. But that's the topic for my next video. Alright, we have established that the current food system is bad. What should Mojang do? Remove the hunger entirely? Maybe, but not necessarily. Let's think about what we actually want, what problem we are trying to solve. So, what we want is the ability to work on a project for a couple of hours uninterrupted and without penalties. A project that is not necessarily close to our base. Also, we want to free a slot in our inventory and in the hotbar in particular. Essentially, you want to leave your base for a couple of hours without food and not be completely and utterly screwed. If we will do this, we will solve the problem. Also, if we can preserve a food-related challenge during the survival stage of the game and in combat, that would be a nice bonus. Why is this a problem though? Why do we have to fix it? But also, why is it fine to have intensive food management during combat all of a sudden? You see, peaceful activities, like resource gathering or building, are flow states. You are fully immersed into just one task you are doing right now, and any unnecessary distraction would hurt the experience. Combat, however, is a different thing. You need to track your health, your gear durability, how much damage you can deal or take, where the enemies are, how much health they can potentially have, how much damage they can deal to you, etc., etc. Combat is about multitasking, managing multiple stats at once, and choosing priorities. Having an additional task to keep your food meter as high as possible actually enriches that experience rather than taking away from it. And now, let's take a look at potential solutions. Solution number 1. Enchanted Diamond Apple / Passive Out of Combat Regeneration. This concept consists of 3 bullet points. It keeps the original mechanics as the default option, but allows you to achieve the alternative mechanics by consuming a very expensive item. With the alternative mechanics, you never have to have food on you unless you are actively looking for a fight. Food is something you would like to have in a fight, but you can either escape a fight or be so good at combat that you dodge anything and can get away without having food. And if this sounds interesting, I have made a data pack you can play with that system right now. You start with your usual food mechanics, but once you have found an enchanted golden apple, you surround it with diamond blocks, you craft an enchanted diamond apple and eat it. Now your food mechanics have been changed and it is preserved between lives. The food bar is gone. You passively regenerate 2 hearts every 10 seconds, but if you take any damage, including fall damage, The passive regeneration is disabled for 20 seconds. This means if you're just building something and taking occasional fall damage here and there, you don't have to think about eating or regeneration at all. But food isn't completely useless. If you will try to fight a pack of mobs, you'll soon realize that without regeneration, they're actually quite threatening. And to have that regeneration when your passive regen is disabled, you eat food. The main argument in favor of this concept is that while you don't have to carry food on you all the time, you can practically live without it. Food still has its meaning when it comes to taking a fight with mobs or other players. Also, potions still have their place too as a superior tier of healing slash regeneration source. But wait, doesn't it mean you have to carry food on you all the time because you face mobs from time to time? Not necessarily. You can take out a single mob without regeneration without any problems. And if you see many mobs, you can just retreat and make them respawn. Having to actually face a pack of mobs is a relatively rare and disruptive activity. The vast majority of time you spend in Minecraft, you spend on gathering resources or building. Also, ender chests exist. You can store a stack of golden carrots in there and take them once in a blue moon when it is necessary to take a fight. I have played for dozens of hours with these food mechanics, and I can confidently say that this design actually works and it is balanced. And you can roll back to the old mechanics by eating a poisonous netherite potato. This is actually a nice bonus of this concept, by the way. Each player can choose their preferred style of food mechanics individually. Solution number 2. Slower, much slower food bar depletion. This concept consists of 3 bullet points. We want to keep the hunger as a thing. We want to make eating as a part of an already existing but less frequent recharge process. And it should be comfortable to play with the half-drained food bar. This concept still requires you to manage the hunger meter, but unlike the current system, where you have to carry food with you all the time, you eat only when you visit your base once in 2 to 3 hours, and you are going to visit your base anyway. It will be a part of the resupply process you do when you drop your stuff at your base and pick other stuff to make the next project. It will be something similar to how you go to an XP farm to mend your gear. You see, with the current system, you get punished almost immediately when your food bar isn't 100% full. As soon as the food bar drops to this level, you don't regenerate anymore, which means full damage starts to accumulate pretty quickly. As soon as it drops here, you can't sprint anymore, and when it is empty, you start to take hunger damage, and soon you die of starvation on the hard difficulty. This is a problem because it means eating becomes a high priority when it is here and not here. You just can't afford to let it be even a little bit drained, or else you'll be half dead all the time. My concept, however, suggests that you don't get punished until your food bar gets completely empty. When it is empty, then your character feels hungry. This is when your regeneration stops, and this penalty alone is enough to give eating a high priority. There is no need in disabling sprinting or causing harm to a player. In fact, the penalty on sprinting actually makes it harder to recharge your food. The current system implies that the empty food bar means that your character is starving for weeks, while my system implies that the empty bar means that you're just hungry. For the hard difficulty, maybe there probably should be a hidden starvation meter, and if you don't eat for way too long after your hunger bar has become empty, then you should actually starve. One question I didn't have enough time to think about is how to handle regeneration and combat. For some reason, I think having that out-of-combat regeneration from the first solution wouldn't fit here. Maybe because you would be forced to have potions on you all the time as the only source of in-combat regeneration. That wouldn't be convenient, what do you think? Solution number 3. Food as the source of long-lasting minor buffs. 3 bullet points. It is an addition to the previous solution, which means you eat once in 2 to 3 hours. To give the variety of food in Minecraft a purpose, most food types should provide minor long-term buffs until you get hungry. Said buffs shouldn't be strong enough to clash with potions, beacons, or be so vital to consider the lack of a said buff as a penalty. For example, if your diet consists of sea salad, your air meter goes 10% slower underwater, or if you eat rabbit stew, you receive 20% less fall damage. Golden Kiaras, for example, could provide a 20% addition to natural regeneration, and so on. The idea of food providing buffs isn't new, however. There is Nutrition mode, where if you eat well across all 5 nutrients, you get major buffs. However, the problem with that mod is that you quickly start to treat the overpowered buff state as the new default, and when you lose those buffs, it feels like a penalty. And once you make a food source that contains all 5 nutrients at once, we're back to square one, having to eat the same thing over and over again to avoid having penalties. What I suggest is having buffs which are neat but can be easily switched off without feeling like you're missing something. Buffs which could be somewhat useful in certain environments but not being a solution to anything. After all, you can pick only one of those buffs. For example, if you work underwater on a regular basis, you probably want to have sea salad as your everyday food source because of its buff to breathing. But it's not a substitute to a conduit for their breathing potions and a respiration helmet. And it wouldn't invalidate potions because potions give you much stronger effects, but for a short duration. For example, while rabbit stew could provide you with 20% fall damage resistance, a slow falling potion gives you 100% resistance. Honey could provide you with a 10% mining speed bonus, but it is less than a beacon that gives you 20% per level. But I have to re-emphasize, as long as you are not skipping your meals every 2-3 hours, you should have a minor buff depending on your diet. Half-broken solution number 4. Food is for the weak. This concept has just one bullet point. Hunger penalties can be ignored outside of combat. You should be able to perform peaceful activities, such as resource gathering or building, with an empty stomach. The issue with this concept is that it is hard to come up with penalties, which would be actual penalties, but not get in the way of peaceful activities. Like, you cannot have death by starvation, for example, inability to sprint, or complete lack of passive regeneration. All of which are penalties of the current system, by the way. What we can have is the attack speed penalty without mining speed penalty, lower regeneration, lower, not lack of, and lower attack damage. Also, we cannot have the maximum health penalty or increased incoming damage penalty. You know why? That's why. If you would have a health penalty, you would probably die 3 times more than you would do with a full stomach, and that's against our goal. But for some reason, I think this solution wouldn't help, and people would carry food around anyway. Maybe because combat penalties would feel like penalties, while my solution feels more like a brand new regeneration system. Or maybe because of this annoying dancing line of empty hunches? Like, things like that annoy so many people, you just feel the urge of filling everything that can be filled. So, I don't think this can be a standalone solution, but as a part of something bigger and better, maybe. Now let's talk about PvP and minigames. Usually, my main argument would be that minigames use modded server platforms like Spigot, and while you can connect with a vanilla client, the server admins can implement any custom logic and any combat and food systems they would like. I have a whole video on why combat update doesn't matter for the PvP community. But for the sake of argument, let's imagine that they are going to use our food mechanics. In today's suggestions, food has had its meaning as the in-combat source of regeneration, so its role in combat basically would stay pretty much the same as it is in the current Minecraft. Maybe it could have some tweaks, like eating being interrupted by taking damage as in the combat snapshots. Who knows? The point here is that you can tweak combat activities and peaceful activities separately within the same overarching food system. Now let's talk about some common suggestions to fix the food problem, which I believe won't work. And we start with the saturation beacon. The idea is simple. When you're within the beacon's range, your food and saturation get refilled. The problem with this idea is that more often than not, you do things outside of your base, like gathering resources or building farms. It is actually bad practice to have multiple farms within the same area. I'm looking at you, and you, and you. Thus, you'll have to take food with you every time you leave your base, and because you'll probably forget to grab food from time to time, it is more convenient to just always have food on you and not even think about it. So, we're back to square one. Automatic feeder item. While this is better than nothing, and if this would be the only thing Moeng would add to address this issue, I would be pretty happy, but this concept is far, far weaker than anything we have seen today. First, it doesn't fit Minecraft. It is subjective, but I think other options would feel much more organic. Second, it still takes inventory slots. Even if you would come up with a feeder that stores food inside the feeder itself, it is still at least one slot permanently taken away. Third, you will often run out of food out of the blue, and with the current hunger system, running out of food puts you in a very vulnerable state where you have to immediately drop whatever you are doing, go to your base, and restock. Different food should give you different buffs, no additional changes. As I've said previously, if you have a strong and useful buff from a certain source of food, that food source will be practically mandatory, because why would you eat an inferior source of food instead? It doesn't really solve the problem of having to eat way too frequently, it just adds the lack of that new buff as an additional penalty on top of existing ones. So, yeah. If I would have to pick my favorite solution, it is probably going to be the enchanted diamond apple. While it won't fix the fact that there are dozens of useless food items in the game, it provides the best player experience, and this should be the ultimate goal. Speaking of best player experience, here's a teaser from next video. Moeng's multiplayer has at least 3 massive design flaws, and if we have to use community developments to fix those, that's not great. Bye-bye.